Hello guys, welcome to the software testing tips and tricks channel. So today's video is about difference between puppeteer and selenium. So these two UI automation frameworks are quite popular, and till now in this channel we have so many videos to learn puppeteer, and I hope like you have some ideas on selenium for this video. So let's start. So before we start, like, please don't forget to subscribe this channel and press the bell icon. So what are the differences? So let's start with the introduction first. Like, puppeteer is developed by Google and released in 2017, so it's quite recent technology. And selenium is originally developed by Jason Huggins in 2004, so we have like 16 years old technology, which is selenium, and most of the organizations are using selenium for their UI automation. So puppeteer is a Node.js library, and as we seen, it is added recently. Selenium is a web framework for testing web applications, so it's a completely different framework made just for automation purposes. So puppeteer is developed by Google, and so by obviously it supports Chrome browser. So first it downloads the Chromium, and it has so much good control on Chromium. By the way, recently started supporting Firefox as well, but it's bit complex to use Firefox with puppeteer. In Selenium, it supports almost all browsers. Other differences, like, it supports only JavaScript. So as it is Node.js library, you need to use JavaScript. But with Selenium, it supports almost all the programming languages like Java, Python, Node.js, C#. So you can hire any of the developer which knows at least one language for Selenium, but for puppeteer, one need to learn JavaScript. Puppeteer is easy to set up, and it won't take much time. Like, you have just to install Node.js and fire a couple of the commands on the terminal or command prompt. So we already have basic video like how to set up and start with puppeteer. Selenium is relatively complex for new user. Like, you have to add jar, set up Java path, environment variables, and somewhat luck. Yeah, puppeteer supports only web automation, no cross platform is supported. But in Selenium, it supports web automation and as well as mobile automation also. Also, it supports cross-platform. So with tool APM, you can actually automate mobile applications. So we will have more videos on that. Yeah, so puppeteer is set as default to run in headless mode, and it can also be changed to watch the execution live in non-headless mode. So with puppeteer, like, by default it runs in headless mode. So whenever you run that, you don't require Chrome to open, and it automatically start with that. But if you want to debug, you can watch execution in non-headless mode as well. So it will be very useful when you are running with Docker and on CircleCI. So everything looks smooth. So with Selenium, running in headless mode is not that easy. You have to do so many setups or use APIs. So it has no recording capabilities, so program skill is must. Like in puppeteer, you can't record and play. Like in Selenium IDE, you can record and play. But for Selenium WebDriver, like, which has more support on webs, web automation, the programming skill is must. So with puppeteer, like, taking from screenshot is very easy. Like, you can have to do like page.screenshot and takes the screenshot, and whatever path you give, it stores there. And you can also have screenshot and PDF. You can crop screenshot at runtime only. With Selenium, like, taking screenshot is little tricky. Like, you have one method and you can use that directly, and it won't support for PDF. So in puppeteer it is very new. Like, community support is very limited. You have some good examples from GitHub and puppeteer, their own website where like you can get explanation of each and every methods for page class, browser class, and whatever supported class it is. But Selenium, you have huge community support. Like there are many Stack Overflow support as well, and so many videos on YouTube as well. Like for puppeteer, like very few videos, and most of them are introductory only. So you can keep subscribe this channel and follow this channel for more puppeteer videos to learn in depth. So now question is like which to use. We have both the technology, both uses UI, Selenium is quite old, Puppeteer is very new. So it all completely depends on your organizers. Like how much support automation QA you have. So first thing is like with Puppeteer, if you are not keen on like testing on multiple browsers, but you just want to run sanity just to verify builds, like kind of testing you can do with Puppeteer quickly and efficiently. Other thing is like if you have automation developers who are not quite familiar with JavaScript or not used to it, then you need to go with other technologies. So here like JavaScript it means more must with Puppeteer. So based on your application, like if you want to concentrate on each workflow, at least it should be automated and run every day and very fast, then go with Puppeteer. And if you are want to run in cross browsers, and also you have programmers who knows more Java and other programming languages, then you can go with Selenium. So Selenium maintenance, whatever from my experience I feel is like maintaining and learning Selenium from scratch for new automation user or automation developer is a little bit tricky, or it takes little bit time. But with Puppeteer one can start directly if he has little bit JavaScript knowledge. So thank you guys, please subscribe this channel, like and share the video. If you have any concern, please comment here. Thank you.